So ating kausapin ang aking kaibigan, makakausap ko ang ilang mga kababayan nating overseas. Di lamang para pag-usapan ang kanilang pag-aalala sa mga naiwang pamilya sa Pilipinas, kundi para alamin na rin ang kanilang mga sitwasyon sa gitna ng pandemya. Mga kaibigang matagal nang hindi nakikita.
Hi Kala! So,
mga kaibigang sila mismo ay direktang naapektuhan.
So, I had some health issues about the whole thing, diba? So,
kaibigang nalagay sa alanganin.
And then after I took medicine, I was fine. And then the next day, yun na, ubo-ubo, tumalala na yung ubo ko, ganyan.
Mga bagong kilalang kaibigang kumapit sa pananampalataya nang sila'y magkasakit.
Na magkakaroon ng third lockdown.
Iba't ibang kwento na di naiiba sa hinaharap natin dito sa Pilipinas. Ito ang kanilang kwento.
Like, let's see if I can do it one-handed. I roll it up like this so it's as small as it can be.
Magandang araw sa inyong lahat. Muli, ako po si Jay Orense para sa Kwentong COVID Pinoy Overseas. Sa oras na ito, may makakausap po tayong kababayan muli na nakabase sa India for the last 9 years. Siya po ay nagkaroon ng COVID-19. Bagamat patuloy po ang kanyang paggaling sa mga oras na ito, siya po ay isang professional photographer, businesswoman, isa pong ina at isa pong may bahay. Atin pong kamustahin si Peach Kamath.
So Peach, before anything else, I know what's happening in India. We all know, we're seeing the news, and our heart is actually really, really heavy whenever we see all those videos na lumalabas. But first, I want to know, how are you? Kamusta ka na? At ano nang sitwasyon mo dyan sa India?
I am getting better. Actually, nagka-COVID ako. This is already my 17th day and my 21st since, okay, or 22nd since I started showing symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
So, I just started coming out of the room since yesterday, pero limited movement pa rin.
Mm-hmm.
But so far, we are okay. Our society, basically, ano siya, heavily impacted ng,
yes,
COVID. Almost all of the residents are down with COVID.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody is just advised to be home quarantined right now because the hospitals are really full.
Peach, I just want to know if you have an idea where you got the virus?
I think it's from one of the parties na dinocument ko kasi I'm a photographer here. And I shot a birthday party, I think last week ng March.
Uh-oh.
Kasi na-realize, doon ko nakuha kasi may isa akong client na small kid na nagkaroon din ng COVID.
Okay.
So, at almost at the same time as me.
Mm-hmm.
Kaso lang, her symptoms were very short. I think it's just like 4 or 5 days sa kanya. Sa akin, mm-hmm, mahaba-haba. So, feeling ko doon ko nakuha yon.
Okay. But hindi mo nadala sa bahay?
Nadala ko kasi yung mother-in-law ko, nagka-COVID din siya.
Oh, wow.
Although she doesn't stay with us, that time, dito siya sa amin. Tapos, just a few days before she got herself tested, bumalik siya sa bahay nila. Tapos doon na nalaman na ano, doon siya nagpa-test. Tapos doon na na-discover na positive din siya. So, I think, yeah.
Oh, so, I hope you don't mind me asking this. Ilan yung sa pamilya mo ang nagkaroon ng COVID? Yung mga anak mo ba? Yung asawa mo? And the other relatives ng mother-in-law mo?
No, it's just me and my mother-in-law. Mm-hmm. Sa bahay naman, so far, negative yung asawa ko. Tsaka yung mga anak ko, they're good.
Mm-hmm.
Made the name, she's okay.
What were your symptoms during that time?
It was nauna yung body pains eh.
Mm-hmm.
We thought we were blaming the aircon pa kasi normally pag aircon, 'di ba, pag tumama sa katawan mo masakit.
True.
Pag the next day masakit yung katawan,
correct,
mo. So yung mother-in-law ko, parang sabay kami pero kasi the next day magkwentuhan kami, sabi, sakit ng katawan ko. Sabi siya, oo nga din eh. Yung AC tapat na tapat sa akin, magre-reklamo kami. Pero we didn't know na yun na pala yun.
Uh-huh.
Masakit eh sa kasukasuan, uh-huh, like in the kidney area, tas sa ribs. Tas yung likod, it has really impacted both our backs. Yung fever later na after 4 days for me,
mm-hmm,
si mommy nagka-fever siya, medyo nandito siya sa bahay noon. I think for a couple of days or so, pero hindi high fever, parang normal lang. Na ano, normal lang siya na lagnat.
Natakot ka ba na, wait, this might be, you know, one of the symptoms of COVID?
I think the entire 2020 has prepared me mentally. Mm-hmm. Na, you know, kasi because of my work, I get really exposed. I'm a wedding photographer here as well. And weddings here, they're not really small, you know. 100 guests for them is really small. So, exposed ako masyado last season. Kaya medyo mentally prepared ako. So, when I, nung medyo na-realize, no, di naman, nung na-realize ko na siguro nga COVID to, prepared na ako mentally. Hindi ako natakot. Kasi I have anxiety. I was diagnosed with an anxiety many years back. And last year, medyo umatake siya. Pero this year, I think because of the experiences that we had and knowledge also. And doctors are now more, medyo, mas ready sila now. Mas may information now. So parang hindi ako natakot. And, but of course, nandyan yan somewhere.
Correct.
Pero for me, since mentally prepared ako, I also had, parang may brain switch ako na parang, okay, if ever magkasakit ako, divert lang. Divert lang ng attention. You have to divert your attention kasi COVID can attack your mental space.
Yes, true.
More than your, I mean, aside sa physical ano mo, state mo, it can really eat up your mental health and it's not good. I've seen a lot of people go depressed or you know, pangit din ang effect niya mentally.
But Peach, were you taken to the hospital? Or
you just... Thankfully not.
Oo nga eh. Kasi
having goosebumps. Thankfully not. Kasi nakakatakot yung...
When you say nakakatakot, tell us why. Ano ba? Bakit siya nakakatakot?
Kasi ano, we live nearby a hospital, two hospitals.
Okay.
And yung isa, kininvert na siya into a COVID hospital. Mm. So, one time when I was advised by the doctor to get my CT scan, syempre dumaan kami doon. And yung pila ng mga ambulance, ang haba. It's unbelievable. Parang alam mo yung, iba kasi yung feeling na you're just in the house and you're seeing all the updates online.
Yes, yes.
Iba yung feeling na nandun kayo na makikita mo yung reality. It's really different. So, nakakatakot. Buti na lang, hindi din ako na-hospital kasi nung na-diagnose ako ng COVID, dun din yung time na nag-peak siya ata.
Yeah, I was about to ask you that. Oo, kasama ka pala dun sa peak at sa surge. Yung case mo.
Oo, grabe. After noon, parang few days lang, 3 days after I was diagnosed, parang ang daming stories, especially sa Instagram, mas active yung mga creatives sa Instagram. So, dun ako maraming updates na people looking for help. Kasi that time, because of the surge, parang unprepared lahat eh. Nobody was really, I mean, I was expecting this to happen. Sorry, I have to go back to this show. I was expecting this to happen kasi there was a cricket game na pina-open nila yung stadium dito.
Yes.
And yeah, so after, no, hindi lang after, kasi ang daming rallies, ang daming religious events na inalaw yung government, tapos may election din. So yung mga political rallies was ongoing. Parang naging super spreader siya kahit yung mga weddings dito.
Are these the reasons why there was a sudden surge? Kasi last year, natatandaan ko, ang dami, even WHO, they were worried about India because of the large population nga. So, yung worry nila. But then it didn't happen. Parang medyo nag-plateau yung number.
Nag-lockdown kasi last year agad eh.
Oo, tapos biglang all of a sudden, bigla na lang, wow, there's a tsunami.
It's because of the events. It's because of the events talaga. For example, even in weddings, right?
Yeah.
Kahit ako double mask ako eh, and the shoots here, they last for 17 to 18 hours sometimes. Yeah. So you have no choice but to wear the mask that long. But kasi nakikita mo yung events dito, ano eh, yung parang yung walang social distancing na nangyayari eh. And it's you really can't avoid mahirap mag-social distance pag events. That's it. Yeah. That's the reality of it.
Kasi may na-interview din ako isang Filipina sa Indonesia and she said na there was a lockdown initially
pero napagod na yung mga tao. They decided not to follow it. Bahala na si Batman. Lalabas kami. Magmamask kami. But if we get the virus, we get the virus. So, dead man na kami sa lockdown. So, may ganun bang psyche rin dyan sa India na parang may cabin fever or complacent na, relaxed na? May ganun din bang pag-iisip?
Meron. Meron. Of course. Meron din talaga. Meron din ako mga kilala na anti-maskers. I don't hold it against them. It's their choice. Pero for me, I just want to practice, you know, yes, proper protocols. Pero yes, meron talaga. Meron talaga na hindi naniniwala that COVID still exists. And then they fell sick because they were not taking precautions. Meron. Mm-hmm. There's a huge group din na parang they don't believe in it.
Since you brought up the non-believers, I just saw this video days ago. He's actually Indian who grew up here in the Philippines, and he said that you know, it's not true that there are 300 cases of COVID daily. So since you are there living in India, tama bang isipin na ang dami-daming kasong nagaganap every day sa India?
Ang dami. I can say this because in the past 3 weeks, I would say, my timeline is really full of cries for help, oxygens, beds, ventilators. And these are just coming from my friends from the creative industry. Hindi pa kasama dito yung mga friends, yung mga kilala ko na nag-work sa hospital.
Yeah.
Or yung... wala, yung laki, hindi ko, ang daming case dito, you cannot, yung sinasabi nila na, yung, kasi may friends din ako ng photojournalists eh, and they're really on the, nasa location sila, they're covering they're covering what's happening in the hospital, and, it's different eh, pag nandito ka, tapos, yung friends mo mismo nag-ask ng help,
yeah,
tapos yung, halos lahat ng friends mo sa community nagkakasakit na rin. Last week lang nagulat ako, almost all of our friends na photographers dito sa city namin, they're all down with COVID.
Oh,
I
wow.
thought it was just me. You know, so at saka I don't know paano siya nag insert sa mask mo kasi yeah. like in my case, it was just a very short span na uminom ako ng tubig at kumain ng cake because he gave me a cake and I had to go excuse myself, go to the garden para doon ako mas safe.
Correct.
Pero since it's a house and it's 25 people, parang cramped up yung space, you know, cramped up yung space and the small celebration lang siya. So siguro, nagsa-circulate lang yung virus doon. We live, like our area, we live in a very safe space, but I can hear the ambulance every time.
How old are you today?
Yung husband ko natatakot minsan, di makatulog kasi mas gusto niya pang madinig yung daan ng pag dumadaan yung train dito sa house namin kasi sa ambulance kasi
mas gusto niya yung ingay ng
ng train kaysa dun sa ambulance. So ang dami, I cannot yung mga ang daming unaccounted deaths, tapos may mga photographer friends ako yung nang currently nagtatrabaho sila sa government sa medical part ng government, sila yung nag-swab test.
Yes.
Ang dami. Tapos, malalaman mo din na madami because yung, for example, results ng COVID tests, we used to get it within 10 to 12 hours.
Yeah.
And then it became 24 hours. In my case, it was 48 hours.
Oh, wow.
Which means, maraming cases.
In your area, like your neighborhood, meron kang alam na ibang nagkasakit din ng COVID diyan sa mga kapitbahay mo or sa community mo, marami din.
Before I got sick, napaligiran kami like kasi here we live in flats, no?
Yes.
So yung mga yung neighbors ko here and on above us, tsaka yung almost lahat ng blocks, eh. Tsaka ongoing yung updates kasi meron kaming WhatsApp group where we update where the management keeps updating who's got COVID para lang maging aware, you know,
correct,
at mag-create ng update na kung sino nagkakasakit in case they need help or something. So, non-stop siya every day yung updates.
But how do you make sure that all of you are safe? Your children, you have 2 young children, I suppose, yung husband mo, your mother-in-law, how do you make sure na everybody's safe?
ano lang, really follow protocols. Basic lang talaga. Wash hands. Like me, I try to stay away as much as I can. Mask talaga is really important. Basic protocols lang. If you follow them, there's a chance talaga that you'll be spared. Although, of course, now, iba na kasi yung variant ng, or iba na yung, yeah, yung strain, iba na now. Dito nag-i-infect na ng kids. Ang funny nga eh, kasi nag-joke pa kami ng mother-in-law ko. When we realized that this is, that we are having COVID, parang sinisi pa namin yung hangin. Ano ba yan? Baka nasa hangin na, kailangan naka-close na lahat ng door, ng window, ganyan-ganyan.
Paano kayo nakalagpas doon sa sitwasyon na you were infected, trying to get better?
Quarantine agad. Yung recovery kasi for mild cases, it's not as hard. Parang pruning, steaming, tapos consult agad sa doctor. Tapos, nung hindi ko pa nakuha yung result ko sa COVID, the doctor already gave me antibiotic to start with. Mm-hmm. So, tapos when I got confirmed, when I got my result, he gave me COVID na medicine tsaka few more antibiotics.
Mm-hmm.
And then rest. When your body needs you to, your body will tell you naman that you need to rest. So sleep, steaming, the usual things. Hot water, mga basic na na recovery tips for mild cases, ganun, like gargle with warm water. Yeah.
Pero may intake ka ba o gamot like remdesivir or
yeah,
yung mga...
I did.
You did?
Yeah. Not that one. For us, it's yung binigay ng doctor for me is Fabiflu. So and it was scary to take the pills kasi you have to take the first dose 4.5 pills. Eh. And I'm not the type of person who likes to swallow pills all the time. I've never had any pills for like a long time.
Ito, I'm sure binabalansin mo yung worries mo. You worry about your family there in India. At the same time, you still have your family here in the Philippines, I suppose. Oh. So, how do you balance yung worries mo and anxieties mo?
Comfort lang siguro na yung mom ko is a really strong woman.
Mm-hmm.
She's not the type who worries a lot. What do you call this? My mom, she's alone. Mm-hmm. She's staying alone right now kasi yung dad ko and my brother, they work abroad.
Mm-hmm.
So most of the time, she's alone and she keeps on, assuring us that she's okay kasi my mom also has comorbidity. She has...
Okay.
Tama ba ko?
Yes.
She's diabetic and she has some heart issues. So hindi lang siya lumalabas and I keep... Mm-hmm. We have a family group where we update each other, keep in touch as much as we can. What do you call this? And since my in-laws also don't stay with us, we reach out through calls, video calls and all. So, yun lang.
It's not easy. It's very difficult. Kasi you have children, you have your husband, you have your family here and there. So parang ang dami nun. How should one handle that situation?
Divert mo muna from the sakit and focus ka on how to get better. That's really important. Kasi if you focus na, oh my God, may sakit ako, then you'll not get better. Dapat yung focus is, how will I get better?
Correct.
Yun yung una sa lahat. And then, you have to shut your brain off from all the negativities. Like for example, ako, I'm a businesswoman. I run my own business here. I have to assure myself na, for example, lugi eh, kasi walang gigs, di ba?
True.
But you have to really think na it's okay, healthy pa ako.
Mm-hmm.
Ganyan. So it's all about shifting your mental focus into something not positive, but also something na, how do I say? Yung focus mo dapat tama lang.
Yeah.
Tapos you need help. So don't hesitate to ask for help. Pray.
Yes.
It's really important to pray. Some people don't believe, but I do believe in prayers.
Mm-hmm.
And insist na magpahinga muna.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi yung bingat from COVID is ano, parang hindi siya maganda eh. Like, mm-hmm. now nararamdaman ko konting movement lang sa kitchen. Pagod ka na.
Yeah.
Parang ganun.
Yeah. So, thank you very much, Peach, for giving us this time. And
I
gusto ko na gumaling ka ng lubusan at hindi maapektuhan ang mga anak mo, especially yung husband mo. And sana gumaling na rin yung mother-in-law mo. So, thank you very much.
Thank you din for your time. I really appreciate it.